It's a pleasure to be back with you for night number two. We had a beautiful message last night.
Yes.
It said, Bishop Grace said, Lord, get me out of this mess.
Yes.
He talked about getting caught in drugs, going backwards and forwards, especially if you're on one of these muddy roads around here and getting stuck in a rut. And who we call to get us out of that rut? The ministers aren't here yet, but we give a hearty welcome to them and the man of the hour that will be with you. And also, first ladies that are in the house, we just welcome you. And right now, we're going to have a selection from our choir.
Thank you.
welcome to everyone. If something is put on your heart or you need to get up and shout and run around the church and just get full of the Spirit, feel free to do so. Amen. We just want to welcome you all. And just hope that you have a great time.
Yes.
Is there someone who can, from one of the visiting churches, can give us a response?
Rest of the Lord.
Rest of the Lord.
This chapter, you know what you need to do.
Yeah, we know what we got to do.
You now in the hand of God.
Look at the neighbors, say, again, we do give honor to God. Thank you for his precious son, Jesus, to our Lord and Savior, to his precious Holy Spirit. Again, we are excited again on tonight to have some great pastors along with us. Thank God for Pastor George Grace being in the house tonight.
Pastor Carlos Johnson and Mount Olive. Amen.
Amen. I was just getting frequent flyer miles of Timpson. And you never, I preach more in Timpson than I did in my home city, which is Nacogdoches. And you never forget those who helped you out in ministry. You never forget those who helped you. And he said he was my principal, so I don't know if he remembered anything that I did, but if he says some stories, don't believe him. Now, if it's good, believe him. But if it's something bad that I did as a freshman in high school, then, you know, don't listen to Pastor Osley. Amen. Amen. I am excited. I'm grateful. I told you I apologize for our church not being here, being the last minute, and I've been ripping and running them this entire year. Well, really, since the 8 months since I've been there, we have gone somewhere at least every month since I've been the pastor of that church. And so I do apologize, but a couple of my youth said, "Pastor, we want to go." And so I said, "Well, I'll pick you up there back there. Wait, stand up. Y'all too, Jay, Zaina, God bless you." Amen. Our mime ministry is here. My armor bearer, he mimes as well. He is going to perform Brother Michael Wilson. He's going to mime a long time, and I'm going to come back and preach a short while. You see, my text is already up there on the screen. I ain't used to that either. But he's going to mime real quick or long, and then we'll come back and see what the Lord has to say through the proclamation of the Word of God. Is that all right? And he said, I just preached six nights in revival. If I can't do all the rearing and tearing, Overseer Graves is here. So all I got to do is just say, hey, just get an early preview of Wednesday night and just holler for me. Amen. Raise the hands of Brother Michael Wilson.
Open up my arms to be receptive and responsive to the preaching of thy word. Take my heart and my health. Hold it both now, sir, in the hollow of thy hand. Pray, Lord God, that you will make my mouth responsible, make my minutes reasonable, but more importantly, Lord, make this message relevant. That when we leave this place, we'll leave more in love with you, more determined to do your will, more knowledgeable of your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. I miss the old church. I'm a young man. I'm probably the youngest, oldest thing in here. I'm 35, but I love old school church music. I like the new stuff. You can bob your head to it. But I grew up on the old stuff. I grew up in New St. Matthew Baptist Church in Nacogdoches, Texas, 2720 Matthew Street. W.R. Rich was my pastor. And growing up in Nacogdoches, there's some songs that we used to sing that they don't sing no more. So if you don't mind helping, but I'm old school. No music, help me out. There are some things I may not know. There are some places that I can go. But I am sure. Sleep on a pillow. They wake him and said unto him, Master, Carest thou not that we perish? He arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace, be still. The wind ceased. There was a great calm. And he said unto them, why are ye so fearful? How is it that ye have no faith? And they feared exceedingly and said to one another, what manner of man is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him? Amen. The grass withers, the flower fadeth away, but the word of our God shall stand forever. I left that off for a reason. Young people need to pay attention tonight. I want to simply talk about for a few brief moments, surviving life's storms. Surviving life's storms. So good to see the pastor of the Sweet Union Church, my friend, Pastor Kevin Boyer. Amen. On this evening. Surviving life storms. Ladies and gentlemen, at the time of this particular passage of scripture, it had been a long, busy day for our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, the day really got started not in Mark chapter 4, but his day really got started in Mark chapter 3, around the 20th verse. Few things took place in that particular passage of scripture. Number one, Jesus had to deal with dysfunction with his loved ones. Because Jesus' family and friends came to see him to try to take him away from him doing ministry because they thought Jesus had lost his mind. And my brothers and my sisters, early on in the introduction of my message, I think I need to tell you that if Jesus had problems with friends and family, you best believe that you are going to deal with your fair share of problems, issues, strife, grief, mess, drama, with friends and family. Everybody that causes you problems, ladies and gentlemen, are not from the outside, but sometimes the problems come with people who share the same last name as you. Ladies and gentlemen, in verse 20, he had to deal with dysfunction with his loved ones. But then, not only did he have to deal with dysfunction with his loved ones, but Bishop Swindle, in verses 21 through 23, he had to deal with lies. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pharisees came to him and said Jesus was possessed by Satan. And said that's where he gets his ability to do the miracles that he does. He is possessed by the devil. They accused Jesus of blasphemy. How could the Son of God, how could the immutable one, how could the King of Kings, how could the Lord of Lords, how could the Ancient of Days, how could the Rose of Sharon be in collaboration with the Prince of Darkness, with the devil of this world? Ladies and gentlemen, that lie sounds so ridiculous. It was probably ridiculous when you heard me say it. But when people can't find anything bad against you, ladies and gentlemen, they will resist. that God will not tempt you, but sometimes he will test you. Because, ladies and gentlemen, a faith that is not tested is a faith that cannot be trusted. And I know, ladies and gentlemen, you can trust and listen to Jesus on the shore, but can you trust and listen to Jesus while you're out there on the sea? And oh, in our fourth chapter, ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says that Jesus Christ would be in a boat with his disciples, and while they were sailing, they came across a storm. The disciples woke him up and said, "Master, don't you care?
Just a
the storm. But then, Pastor Johnson, y'all read the text too fast. Secondly, it may appear as though God isn't doing anything. I said it may appear. Notice verse 38. They're in a storm. These experienced fishermen are frightened for their lives. They're scared. They're trying to figure out what's going on. Things were fine 1 minute.
Yeah.
And then it was rough the next. They're over there scrambling and running. Can't you see them? But look at Jesus. Jesus is down in the hinder part of the ship. Sleep. He's sleeping. Here are these disciples. Strained, they're struggling, they're stressed. Blood pressure to the triple digits. And it seems as though Jesus isn't doing anything. Ladies and gentlemen, how many of us have been in our storm and we feel as though God ain't doing nothing? Be honest with the preacher tonight. Take the pseudo halo off your head. Take the mask off your face. It's okay to admit that when you've been in your storm, you felt as if God isn't doing anything. Has God ever seemed silent while you're going through your storm? Has God ever, ladies and gentlemen, have you felt like you could not hear or discern the voice of God while you were in the midst of your crisis? These disciples were panicked and frightened, and Jesus was asleep. But could you blame Jesus? I just told you, he had a long day. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus was not half man and half God. Lord have mercy. I wish I had a church here. Jesus was not half man and half God. He was fully percent human and fully percent God at the same time. And if I had time, I would tell you, I'm glad that Jesus was 100% human, because I would not want to serve a Savior who could not relate to my reality.
Amen.
But then thirdly, if you're not your storm, fear can replace faith. Boy, I'm a Bible preacher. It's right here in the text. Look, ladies and gentlemen, look at verse 38. The B section of verse 38. First of all, they doubted his goodness. Don't you care? Do you not care? They woke Jesus up, and the first word they accused Jesus of not caring about them. How many times have we seen Jesus work a miracle in somebody's life because he was moved with compassion? These disciples have seen Jesus work miracles out for everybody, and yet when they're in that storm, they woke them up and said, "Don't you care, Lord? Don't you care that the doctor says it's stage 4 cancer? Lord, don't you care that my marriage is headed toward divorce court? Lord, don't you care that my child is locked up? Lord, don't you care that my family member is suffering from this addiction? Lord, do you not care?" If you're not careful, your storms will make you doubt some things about the Lord that you should not be doubting in the first place. They doubted his goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, but then, Pastor Boyer, they doubted his grace. Carest thou not that we are perishing? Lord, we are about to die. Don't you care that we are about to succumb to this storm? Don't you care that we are about to die in this predicament? Lord, do you not even care that the storm is getting ready to take us out? I think I need to tell somebody here tonight, It was going through their storm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Jesus Christ did not go through the trouble of saving you to abandon you. Especially when things get tough in your life.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus Christ is absolutely committed, and he is focused, and he is faithful when it comes to you.
Yeah.
Wish I had a witness in here. Yeah. How do y'all recognize and realize what the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 13, verse number 5 is true?
Yeah.
I wish I had. See, if I had some Bible readers, you would get shouted right along there. I said in Hebrews chapter 13, verse number 5 is true.
Says, I see cars back there. He says, exactly. Everybody that pulled over is still in that storm.
Yeah.
us that the sovereign is still in control. Jesus is still in control. Yeah, because the Bible says that all Jesus had to do was just open up his mouth. And when he opened up his mouth and he said, "Peace be still," the Bible says that the wind and the waves stopped. And ladies and gentlemen, I
faith come back. You'll take over. Hallelujah. We give honor to God again. Thank God for all of you. Amen. Anybody have a good time on tonight? Hallelujah. Anybody that's not going to leave here the way you came?
Any other announcements from the floor?
All right, amen. We're glad to have Pastor Chalk Johnson with us here on tonight. Thank God for him. Amen. Glad to have Pastor Stanley here on tonight. Hey, by the way, y'all got words. Y'all got anything y'all need to hear? Okay, all right. Pastor Boyer, glad to have MSWE Union in the house. Thank God for him. Pastor Rose, thank God for him on tonight. Thank God for him. Amen. Thank God for Bishop Swindle being here with us on tonight. Again, thank God for all the first ladies. Again, thank God for our speaker, Lord Will, on tomorrow. Overseer Gray, that we close us out at EW Liam. Eagle Wing Ministry will be here on tomorrow night, so we're looking at him. And again, we want to thank God for our relief preacher on tonight who came in. Amen. We called in the right. And he showed up and showed out and let God use him. Amen. So on that note, Pastor Tuck, we indebted. Thank God for you. I would say the last words, but I don't want those to be last words. So just close us on.
Thank you, Pastor Osmond, for this preaching privilege to all these fellow preachers, all our fellow preachers of the gospel. God bless you. I believe in the law of reciprocity. I believe in showing up, not when you're just on to preach, but to support. Unfortunately, we have Bible study on tomorrow night in Kilgore, so I will not be able to hear this preacher in person who I've heard so much about, and it's finally a blessing to meet him in person. Amen. I was told, don't go back. There was a couple of preachers that if you go by carpets, you have to see, and Overseer Graves was one of those preachers, but I am so, I do feel bad for me not being able to come back tomorrow to support this great revival, but I am praying for him because I know he's guilty of preaching. Amen. Him and the Bible are on speaking terms. If the preacher and the Bible are not on speaking terms, then something is wrong. Amen. Something is wrong. Amen. We're standing. Amen. We're standing. New hope, my people, my youth. God bless y'all. Thank y'all so very much for traveling with your pastor. You are my favorite members because you are the members that are here. Amen. Y'all see how that works? And whoever comes, they're the members who are the favorites. Amen. Amen. Let's want to join in a word of prayer to close out this. Father God in heaven, on tonight we say thank you. We thank you for telling us and teaching us that we can survive the storms, that we should not let our fear of our storms cause us to doubt your goodness and your faith and our faith in you. Lord, we pray that this word that we have heard tonight will be applied to our lives for the living out of our days. Bless this church. Bless Overseer Graves on tomorrow night. Give him and his church family travel in grace and arrive in mercy. Lord, let it not be a night of usual revival, but Lord, let your spirit take over on tomorrow night. We know that you have prepared him privately, but bless him publicly in the proclamation of the word of God, that the church may be revived, that the sinner might come to you, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we ask you to bless every pastor, every church that is represented here, Lord. We're living in these dark and damp days where right is wrong and wrong is right. Help us to be a beacon of light in this world. Help us to stand and to declare that there is a reality and serving a true and risen Savior. Now, Lord, we know that there's danger from where we are to where we have to go. Please, Lord, sir, guide us as we drive to our homes. Lord God, whether it be near or far, and Lord God, when we arrive home, allow all to be well in the name of Jesus. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling, able to present you faultless before the presence of the Lord, and exceeding joy.